Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. And today I'm in Royal Forest. It's a beautiful day. In here there's no wind and very calm. So I decided to make a new video about my bell kit, my bushcraft bell kit. It is the most popular video I ever made. It has almost been seen 600,000 times. So I'm very grateful for that, and I think it's cool. This is 2.5 years since I made this video, and of course I've upgraded some things. Some things I have found out I didn't need, and I call this a combo kit. And a little bit later I'll tell you why. But now I'm going laid out on my reindeer hide and show the details in my new bell kit. Hope you enjoy. So hang on. Yeah, and this is my basic bell kit that I have with me, on me, almost every time I'm out in the woods. And I think I'll start with this end. This little one is to attach my GoPro remote control, and I'm using it now, so I have it over here. But it's always close to me, so I can use that. And in here, this is something new. Yeah, this one. This one is one I have bought in USA on the internet. I'll see if I can find a link to it. And it's what I call a Lee lighter. And I'll tell you why. First of all, it's made of brass. You know I love brass. And there's a nice compass here. And very good compass. I tested it and it's really great. Inside there is some rubber rings that can prevent this from being wet. It is 100% waterproof. And in here I have some matches, some storm matches. I call it Lee because, first of all, if I'm lazy I can use this to light my fire. It's easy. And the E for emergency. If I ever need to light a fire when I'm cold and I have to do it quickly, I can use this. So my Lee fire maker, I can call it. And then my little bag that I made myself, stitches together with leather. On this side, and this is new too, on this side I have a little knife, a D2 knife. It's very great, I love it, and well, it's carbon steel, and I think it has a nice shape. So this is always here on my little bag. And on the other side I have this Viking fork that I can use when I eat my my meals out in the woods, my steaks and so on. And you've probably seen me use this a lot of times. And in here, the antler here, I've changed that to a smaller one, and when you can see, it's a real antler. I love that. And in here, in my little bag, first of all, I have this little kit, and inside this, and this is electrical tape, we call it, you can use as tinder too. And in here I had a lot of stuff. I have some sawing kits, a battery, a fatwood stick with some birch bark on, a little nice ferro rod I got from Peter from Switzerland. Is actually one that you can put in your Victorinox knives, your Swiss Army knives. And yeah, that's it. I have a lot of stuff, buttons and these straps that I can use also in emergency situation. So I think this is something I had last time too. And next is my little tinderbox, my Hudson Bay tobacco tin, which can be a little bit difficult to open, but In here, I have my fire striker and some flint, and I also got a little bit of char cloth, but mostly amadou, the way I prefer to make my fire. And this is new because for 2.5 years ago, I didn't make a fire this way with amadou. So this is new. And beside that, I still have this little canister for Enfield rifles. And in here, there's oil, so I can oil my carbon steel knife. Very great, very cool. And a little brass container with some resin in. I have to fill it up, I can see. But this one I can collect resin in. And then I have a little multi-tool from Victorinox. And there's a lot of things in here. I won't show you all. A little screwdriver in here. But mostly I use this when I'm preparing my my amadou. I can cut it up in small pieces. And there's also a little saw. See if I can find it, yeah. So when I'm preparing my amadou, I rip it up so it's a bigger surface that I can light with a spark. This is very handy. What else? Oh, there's a little bit of natural cordage. I think this is, jute twine. And in here, this is not new. I have some cotton, which is very nice for tinder and when you're going to start a fire. And this is just ordinary cotton, nothing on it, oil or Vaseline or something, just ordinary cotton. And a paracord. And this is actually compound because I still have my strap here. Yeah, in here. This is a DC4 sharpening stone. Let's see if I can get it out. Yeah, a DC4 sharpening stone. It's quite new, so I haven't used it much, but it's very cool and very nice sharpening stone. And on this I have leather, so it's a leather strap, and I use this compound on it. And on this side I have my little Opinel saw, and it's recently I got it, so I have used it sometimes here during the Kimber Camp series, and I love it very much. It's old school, and as you can see, I customized it a little bit. Opinel is always very flat here, so I rounded it up and made it more me. And of course, I got my my knife with me, my SE5, which I love very much. And on this side, on my previous video, I had a special place for my ferro rods and striker. Now I'm attached it to my sheet, so it's always handy here. And this one is a striker too, but I actually prefer this striker that comes with this ferro rod. It is very, very good. And again, put it in here and lock it down, and then it won't fall off. And finally, in my basic kit, I have this little perch or bag that I've got from a subscriber too, from Germany, I think. It's really cool. And in here I have a little Altoid tin, and in this I have applied something that many of you has asked me about. What about a first aid kit? And of course, in here I have some plaster and some cotton to wipe up if there's any blood. And I got my little flashlight here, which I love very much. It's compact and small, and I can have it in here. And I have some other stuff here. I have some tissues that will clean any wounds, and a little scissor too. So, but plaster, I think it's called, is the thing that I will use mostly if I'm going to have a little cut. So, but this is my my basic kit that I have on me every time I'm in the woods. Now I would like to tell you why I call this video for a combo kit video. Bushcraft combo belt kit video. It's a long word, but sorry. But I just cleaned it up and I'll show you why. Hang on. Yeah, and now I'll show you why I call this a combo kit. Last time I made a video, I had this little axe on. And I still have the opportunity. I can put it on my belt, but it's a little bit heavy. And when I walk with this, I have to make sure that I have to need it. I'm gonna need this. But this one I can put on anytime I will, I wish. And it's a part that has served me well for many years. So this is the one, number one attachment I can use. And another one is this little water canteen from Farino, I think it's called. It has, well, it is orange. I don't like it, but luckily it has this little perch for it. We can isolate it so it will be kept cool for a long time. And I made this little holster, a sheath for it. And I have a belt clip on, so I can clip it on anytime I will. And I've chosen this because it's not very wide. This is number two. And number three is this little flashlight that I showed you in my video, the last overnight I did from True Lights. It's a very, very great flashlight. And I told you then that I will go to put it on my belt kit. But of course, only if I'm going out and I know it's going to be dark. Then I'll attach this to my belt. And another thing I had on my previous belt kit is this little pouch that I can use when I'm out in the forest and collecting tender mushrooms and so on. It's a nice thing to have. It's actually a large pouch, and there can be a lot of stuff in here. And the one I had then was from Max Suspicion, and this is actually the same one. I only made a leather sheet for it, so it's in here. And this one I also can attach to my belt. And the last thing, and the new thing I made myself, not this little bag. I made that for a couple of months ago, no, years ago. And there's a cross here because I used it for my first aid kit. But now I have made it, customized it to something else. And I'll show you what. In here I have my little Sawyer Mini, so I can purify water wherever I am, and a little cloth so I can filtrate the water if it's very dirty. And this one is going for the Sawyer Mini. And in here I have my little plastic bottle that I can collect water in. I've showed that before in a video, so we won't do it again. But in here I made it so it can be fit down here very nicely. And when I'm bringing this, I always can be sure that I can have some clean water with me. So this is the stuff, my combo kits. I think I'll lay it out for you here. Yeah. I don't think I ever will put this all on my bell kit. It will be too heavy. But if I'm going out and I know it's going to be dark, or I'm going to make an override, I can have this. If I want extra water with me, I can use this. Or I can find a pond or a little lake I can purify my water in. And I can collect tinder and mushrooms and other things in this little pouch. And of course my little axe, my little hatchet that I can have with me, together with my saw and my knife. Then I think I'm pretty much covered with most of the things that I can meet out in the woods. I can also attach my Kimber tarp to my belt kit. You can see it here. Yeah, I just used the straps for my ground cloth, and I can put it on my belt. And this is because the Kimber tarp is very light and very compact when it's rolled together. So, and now I'm using the Kimber tarp for shelter when I'm going to make my coffee. But this will be in my combo kit too.